السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام.
Good morning to everybody. الحمد لله الحمد لله كثيرا. We pray صلاة الصبح. نشكر الله كثيرا that he hosted us in his home today to pray صلاة الصبح جماعة. And we're asking him to accept it and put it in our حسنات إن شاء الله.
آمين.
الحمد لله والشكر لله ولا إله إلا الله. اللهم ارحمنا، اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم ارزقنا، اللهم اهدنا. آمين يا رب العالمين. فمن يهدي الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله.
صوت.
Okay. I'm getting the request from Ali. Okay, Ali. Yes, I will. Okay. I will. Alhamdulillah. We're still talking about the battle of Badr. Okay? And the preparation, what happened before, and how the Gaysh Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is getting there, and Quraysh is starting to gather as much as possible to go and help Abu Sufyan when he's coming from Sham in his trip, okay, and towards Badr, the place called Badr over there. And we talked about how big Gaish Abu Sufyan will be, like 1300 fighter versus Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam army was about 300 fighter, and they have two horses here, and we have 200 horses there, 70 camel here, and 700 camel. So there is a big. So Quraysh thought that this is going to be really, it's a victory for them, okay, and they're going to demolish the army of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay. And Abu Jahl, As ignorant as he always is, okay, he's as ignorant as he is, but when it comes to generosity, he's generous. He donated one whole camel full, you know, with a big pot of liquor, okay, for his army to go, okay, and so now you see, really, you know, that the army of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam just went out. They didn't really want to fight. All what they wanted just only to get, you know, the merchandise and getting their money back. That's all. Okay, but the army of Abu Sufyan is actually there. Okay, they are really challenging Allah and Muhammad, and just want to put that religion down the earth. Okay, and we talked about all of those things. I'm just reminding you with it. Okay, now let's see why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam chose the place which is Badr. Badr is called Badr. Badr is a place southwest of Al-Madinah. So here you have Mecca, like that, for example. This is Al-Madinah. This is Badr. So Badr is southwest of Al-Madinah. Okay? It's about 150 kilometers from Al-Madinah. Mecca is about 450 kilometers from Al-Madinah. Okay, so we're talking like a triangle, okay, here. So, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he chose Badr because he knows that the caravans coming from Sham in their train, coming back in their way to Mecca, they stop at that place because that place has so many wells of sweet water. They stop there, they drink, they relax, rest, and feed, you know, or water their camels there. So it's a place where everybody coming from there, you know, passing through it. right before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam arrived to Badr, okay, he sent two people to Ayun, two people to find out, just to see how things are around there. He sent the two people to investigate or to find out what the story over there. Abu Sufyan now is coming towards Badr, okay? And he's coming very cautious because he heard that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in his way to meet him. He's a chicken, okay? Coming, you know, very, very cowardly and coming very close, you know, towards Badr. Then Abu Sufyan, before he reached Badr, he just stopped the caravan and he went by himself to find out what's going on there. Okay. And he went to the people of Badr tribes, people living in this area, and asked them, did you see any army? Did you see Muhammad? Did you see anybody from Quraysh? He's talking about the support coming to him from Mecca. He's trying to gather information. So he's asking the people there, did you see all of those things? So they told him, we haven't seen anybody except Hussein. We saw only two people. Those are the Ayun, Sayyidina Muhammad, the two guys, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, we only saw two people just came into that place here and they sat down, okay, and drank water and then they left. So now he's getting really worried more and more, all right? So what he did, where did they stop exactly? They said, oh, just that place in here. So Abu Dahab, as dirty as he is, okay? He is dirty, okay? Abu Sufyan, yes. Abu Sufyan just took, we're talking bad about Abu Sufyan now because he hasn't really declared his Islam yet, okay? But he's gonna be eventually, radiallahu anhu.
He's a Sahabi.
Sahabi, Jaleel, يعني, he had very good fingerprints with the Islam and the Deen.
He lost one of his eyes.
Yes, yes. Okay, and so anyway, he went to that place and he took part of that rawat al camel, the poops of the camels, okay, in his hand, and he just looked at it and he found that the bits of some dates in there. Mm-hmm. He said, oh my God, this is the dates of Yathrib. This is the dates of Alaf bta Yathrib. This is the dates of the food of they gave it to the horses and the camels in Yathrib. Oh, Muhammad must be very close to here. So his anguish became even worse now. He's getting more scared and more frightened. And he said, you guys, told his caravan, okay, let's not follow the regular way. Let's go towards the sea, the seashore. We're gonna go to the seashore, way down southwest, okay? Down, and we walk in there. This is actually place nobody, this route, nobody takes this one, so we're trying to misguide Muhammad, okay? We're not gonna follow the normal route to Badr. We'll just go to another route, which is around, you know, along the seashore, okay? And then he thought that, okay, he saved his caravan. So he sent in this kid who felt safe now, is away, and he sent it back to his army, which is coming to him. He said, you guys, okay, my caravan is safe, okay? You don't have to worry. You don't have to send me anything. Just to go back to Mecca. Just, I don't need anybody, okay? Anyway, so the army is coming from Mecca, okay? Heard that, and then he started going back to Mecca. He said, Abu Sufyan is the leader of the caravan, and he said that the caravan is safe. Okay, so why do we have to go there? Let's go back. Okay. Anyway, but Fir'aun al-Ummah, okay, who is Fir'aun al-Ummah? Al-Ummah, Amr ibn al-Sham, Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl. He didn't like that. He was coming with that people coming from Mecca, but he didn't like. He said, "No, we're not gonna make a U-turn and go back. Okay, we're gonna go to Badr. We're gonna stay 3 nights, 3 days there. We're gonna celebrate. Okay, we're gonna nanhur al-guzur. We're gonna slaughter the camels. We're not on the ta'am and we feed the people and drink liquor and having dancers and singers and music and everything. We're gonna be having a big celebration, big party." Okay, that's what they were doing right now. Okay, the history actually, you know, repeats itself now. Okay, and Saudi Arabia, they're doing that now, dancing and singing and everything, you know. I mean, يتمثلوا بقريش أيام الجاهلية. Okay. Anyway, Allah المستعان. And he said, "We're gonna be doing that in public, okay? So the people will still know that we are strong and will still respect us, okay? And we're still having the upper hand among all the Arabs. He is arrogant. He's an idiot. He doesn't know what he's talking about. And inshallah, Rabbana hayaksib bil ard. Iznillah." Okay? Anyway. So, they heard that, okay? And one guy who's really wise guy among this army of Abu Sufyan coming from Mecca. One wise guy, okay? Not arrogant like him, or not unwise like Abu Jahl, okay? His name is Hakim ibn Huzam. If you guys remember, you know, maybe 4 or 5 weeks ago, we talked about Hakim ibn Huzam. Hakim ibn Huzam, actually, his aunt is Khadija bint Khuwailid radiallahu anha, zawjat al-Rasul al-Ula, okay? This is his aunt. You remember when she went and visited him and he gave her Zayd ibn Harisa as a slave for her, and she took it and went back to home, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he freed him. Okay, you remember that. So Hakim is actually a wise guy. He stood up among all the army and he said, he's just talking to himself, "We don't really need this one. I'm gonna go and talk to Utbah ibn Rabi'ah." Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, okay, it's another guy. And Utbah ibn Rabi'ah is actually the father of Hind, zawgat Abu Sufyan, okay? He is the grandfather of Muawiyah ibn Abu Sufyan, right? Utbah ibn Rabi'ah. So he said, "I'm gonna talk to..." And Utbah ibn Rabi'ah actually was being killed in Badr by Hamza. He killed him. But he said, "I'm gonna go and talk to, I don't care about what Abu Jahl is saying, but I'm gonna go to and talk to Utbah." So he went to Utbah, he said, "Yeah, Utbah, okay, you are the oldest among us. You are the most respected among us, and your words are always obeyed by us, okay? I don't see any reason why do we have to continue and go and fight, okay? Abu Sufyan already told us his caravan is safe. Okay, so we are really no need. We have no need for this fight." He said, "Well, yes, I agree, but who's gonna guarantee for me, you know, from that Jahl, Abu Jahl? Okay, he is gonna be getting mad." Okay, he said, "But just to go and tell the people that, okay, that we don't really need." So he stood up. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah stood up. He's kafir also. Okay, so far. So he stood up and he said, "Ayyuha an-nas, you people, you heard that your merchandise, your money, your caravan is safe, okay? And we know we are no longer in need for this fight. Why do we have to continue going to this fight? There's no reason, okay? And I see that if we did that, it's gonna be extending for years and years. And eventually we're gonna look at each other, okay? We are all from Quraysh, we are all from Arab, you know. we're going to look at each other. This guy is going to say, this guy killed my father, this guy killed my brother, this guy killed my uncle, and we are all same family, same group. Why do we have to do that when we become enemies to each other? We don't need that. Okay? So leave Muhammad as he is. Okay, let him do whatever he wants. If Allah make him victorious, Muhammad is among, it's one of us. That's good for us. If a'azzahu Allah, this is actually good for us. If he did not win anything, or Allah didn't really let him down, okay, then now you're happy. If that's what you want. So just leave Muhammad and stay away from this war. I don't see any reason to continue for this war. Okay. Then Abu Jahl stood up and started intimidating Utbah. Started intimidating him, telling him bad words. Okay. What bad words? I don't know. You're a coward. You don't want to go. You don't join our group. What happened to you? Why let us down? So Utbah ibn Rabi'ah got so mad and he said, okay, I am going to the war. Okay? So he decided to go, okay? And he started going there. Most of the people of the army of Abu Jahl, which is coming from Mecca, okay, they agreed with Abu Jahl. Still Abu Jahl has a big word, okay? Except those people from Qabilat Banu Zahra. Qabilat Bani Zahra. Bani Zuhra. Bani Zuhra. We said that. Remember when Atika saw the dream, and we talked about that last week, Atika saw the dream that the one guy coming 3 days before Damdam came in and saw the dream, and Damdam dropped a big piece of rock, and the rock become fragmented, you know, pieces, and went to all houses, you know, in Mecca, except the houses, those belong to Qabilat Bani Zuhra. Okay. So here, the Ru'ya had became true. Everybody followed Abu Jahl, except those people which are from Bani Zuhra. He said, we're not going to go with you. So now the army, the number of the army in Abu Sufyan, now reduced from 1,300 became 950 people. Okay, so, but they continued. They continued to go. Right, now. Now, Quraysh is going to Badr. Okay, and some news, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had some news that Abu Sufyan, actually he took another route around the seashore. So Rasulullah, he got the news, so Rasulullah, he knows that he's going there, okay? And also he knew that Abu Sufyan is asking the people coming from Mecca to support him. Okay. Now, let's see the area of Badr. The area of Badr is actually, it's like a valley, big valley. Okay, and the valley, you know, it's between two heights. So the sides of the valley is two heights. Side this side, and then a flat area in between, big huge area between, but there's like a high side and this way, and the side which is closer to Al-Madina, they call it Al-Udwa Al-Dunya. Al-Udwa means some place which is really high. Al-Udwa Al-Dunya, closer to Al-Madina. And the other side which is closer to Mecca, okay, is called Al-Udwa Al-Quswa. Okay, and we'll see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing exactly the geography of the battle, Al-Udwa Al-Dunya, and we'll talk about that, Al-Udwa Al-Dunya, but I'm just giving you an idea. What is Al-Udwa? Al-Udwa means a high place, which is a half of the Wadi, high. Al-Dunya, because it's Dunya, it's closer to Al-Madina. Al-Quswa, because it's far away from Medina, but it's closer to Mecca. Okay, now, So when Qafilat Abu Sufyan, when Qafilat Abu Sufyan arrived to Al-Udwa Al-Quswa, okay, now they sat down, relaxed there, and not Qafilat Abu Sufyan, Qafilat Gash coming from Mecca, okay, coming from Mecca, which is led by Abu Jahl, came to the Al-Udwa Al-Quswa, the Anakhu, put the camels to rest, drinking and relaxing, okay. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his army, by that time, he's already arrived to Al-Udwa Al-Dunya. Okay, so they are here and those are here, okay. Then, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by himself, see the leader by himself, he goes, ask, fight, go with the people. Okay, doesn't stay in Doha, and in Doha watching the war on the TV like us. Okay, by himself he goes. Okay, really. I mean, this is the fact. Unfortunately, yeah, I hope we can really learn from that. Okay, but anyway, by himself he took Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu with him and he went to one guy, some Sheikh Ragil, old person over there. His name is Al-Damari. You call him Al-Damari. In the area of Badr, they wanted to find out. So they went to him and they told him, don't you have any news about from Quraysh or even from Muhammad and Ashabu? He doesn't know them. So they're asking him, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, they're asking that old guy, do you have any news? Do you know anything about Quraysh, Gashm Quraysh, or about Muhammad and Ashabu, you know? Do you know anything? He said, who are you guys? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, we will tell you if you tell us. If you answer our question, okay, tell us, and we will tell you who we are. He said, all what I know that I heard that Muhammad and his army, his companion, they went to meet Qafila, caravan coming from Sham, okay, to get their merchandise. And they are, by now they are, that happened in such a day, and by now probably they are in that place. He just pointed out to Al-Urwa Al-Dunya. Okay? Al-Udwa Al-Dunya, Al-Udwa Al-Dunya, okay? If the whoever told me he's true, he must be at that place by now. And also I heard that Abu Sufyan also is coming from Sham, okay? And he asked for, he's telling them what he heard. And he asked the people from Mecca to come and help him, okay? And at that day, such kaza and kaza, that's the day, okay? But if that is true, what whoever told me that, so Abu Sufyan must be somewhere in this place. Okay, and then he said, I heard later on that Abu Sufyan was so tricky and he didn't really follow the regular route. He just took go around the seashore. So he's telling them exactly what happened, okay, what he heard. Then he told them, okay, you guys, I already told you what I know. You now tell me who you are, where are you from? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told them, we are from water. From water, okay? And they left. Rasulullah and Abu Bakr left. Abu Bakr looked up behind him and looked at the guy. He said, from water? What is this? What do you mean from water? What water? Then Rasulullah looked at Abu Bakr, found Abu Bakr is just wondering. He said, why Abu Bakr? What is the matter with you? He said, ya Rasulullah, what is this answer? And what you told him that we are from water? What do you mean from water? And he said, yes, I'm in Ma'am al-Iraq. No. He said, well, ya Abu Bakr, we answered him correctly and truthfully. Okay, we are أخبرناه أجبناه وصدقناه and we told him the truth.
توريه.
We are, yes, this is actually توريه. You say something, it means something else. Okay, yeah. And he said, يا أبو بكر, don't you remember? Okay, فلينظر الإنسان مما خلق, خلق من ماء دافق. That is سورة الطارق. Verses 5 and 6. So let the man consider of what he is created. He is created from flowing water. Okay. So Rasulullah لا يكذب. Rasulullah always talking the truth. Quran. Okay. And he told him, we told him that enough today. We'll continue tomorrow. Allah يخليك. Any questions, any corrections?
And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, I am from water. We are from water.
We are from water.
The man, he was from, the man said, oh, so, water, the place in Iraq.
Yeah.
And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he meant water. We be created from water.
Yeah. Yes.
He did not lie, but he...
Yes.
Yeah. You got a shikaha? Dua doctor.
Yeah, dua. Allahumma inni da'an fa aminu.
Allahumma aminu.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم أقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك.
آمين.
ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك.
آمين.
ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا.
آمين.
اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا.
آمين.
واجعله الوارث منا.
آمين.
واجعل ثأرنا على من عادانا.
آمين.
ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا.
آمين.
ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا.
آمين.
ولا مبلغ علمنا.
آمين.
ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا.
آمين.
يا رب أخرج من أجسامنا كل شر.
آمين.
كل شر.
آمين.
وكل مرض.
آمين.
وكل سم.
آمين.
وكل سحر.
آمين.
وكل عين.
آمين.
وكل حزن.
آمين.
وكل هم.
آمين.
وكل غم.
آمين.
وكل ضيق. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Thank you very much. الحمد لله رب العالمين.